today we are going to talk about something interesting. We are going to talk about the non-conventional trademarks. We all know how in the era that is ruled by aggressive marketing, different techniques are adopted to grab customers' attention. This is where non-conventional form of a trademark comes to light. Non-conventional trademarks are also known as non-traditional trademarks. To make it easy for you, these trademarks are those marks that are beyond the sphere of traditional trademarks and thus comprise non-visual marks, such as taste, sound, smell, texture, etc. Now, before moving on to the four best non-conventional trademarks that we are going to discuss in this video, let's understand about the trademark in brief. What is a trademark? A trademark is any sign or a mark that is used to distinguish the products or services of one individual from the other to ascertain the origin of such products as well as the services. A trademark only refers to logos, words, or symbols. This notion is not entirely true, since logos, symbols, as well as words are not only marks fitted of being applied as a trademark for one's company or any business. With the inception of a development of intellectual property law, there are different types of marks, such as smell, sound, shape, texture, and taste, that can be trademarked. These developments have manifested in different manners, and the most distinguished of which is the International Agreement on TRIPS, that is, trade-related aspects of intellectual property rights, that lays down the meaning as well as precise minimum standards related to the intellectual property rights comprising the trademarks. And now let's move on to four non-conventional trademarks. First, sound marks. It is a kind of mark where a sound is used as a trademark, as the name suggests. Sound plays a vital role in business recognition. With the increase of social media platforms utilizing audio features such as YouTube, Shorts, Instagram Reels, etc. Now, usually these are two crucial requirements for the registration of sound marks. The application of trademark registration should state that the mark applied for is a sound mark. Graphical depiction of the same should make in the form of musical notations, or where possible, the sound must be capable of being expressed on the paper. However, not all forms of sound marks are registrable if the sound mark asked for is not unique in nature. It may be denied registration. For instance, in year 2013, a beer company, Anheuser-Busch InBev, applied for a registered sound mark which covers two clicking sounds at intervals directed at matching the beer sound can opening. The inspector moved to extent of video recording in himself opening a beer can along with a can of Coca-Cola and noted that this company's sound mark was not unique as all beer cans made the similar sound when opened. And hence, for sound mark to have great chances of being registered, make sure that it is unique and not generic, such as snippets of famous music or other sounds, and that you own the copyright of the sound being applied for. Then we have color marks. Colors are one of the significant things to be observed by the folks, and hence it's most cautious about utilizing this initial impression at the time of creating a business identity and value. Marks that utilize at least one color to get a distinct and unique identity concerning products and services are referred to as color mark. Such marks are likely to be registered as a single color or as a substitute color combinations. Far from conventional trademark registration, a color mark can be trademarked only if it has already attained a unique feature due to its use in trade. The color is sufficient enough to classify the source of products and services. If we go into examples of the trademarks allowed to a combination of color, consists of the green and yellow applied on John Deere tractors and the green circle of the Starbucks on white cup, thereby supplementing to its uniqueness. Now moving on and understanding smell marks. Only a few smell marks have been registered to date. Sounds very weird, right? In the known case, Deutsch patent and mark named versus Rolf Sickmann, a German patent attorney, had filed an application for a smell mark for the chemical methyl cinnamate. They made efforts in the direction of representing the smell with their chemical formula and also stated that the scent was balsamically fruity with a tiny hint of cinnamon. The trademark for the order was refused by the German Office of Trademark and the ECJ as it held that the chemical formula was not sufficient to deduce any smell. Moreover, the representation of the smell needs to be clear and precise. The position of India on registering smell marks is the same as that of EU in the case of Royal Sick Man. Although the Trademark Act and rules present for the smell marks registration, not a single smell mark has been registered in India till now, and no guidelines have been published by the Trademark Registry concerning how to show smell marks graphically. Then we have 3D or shape marks. When a final product can be identified on the basis of its shape as well as its packaging, then a three-dimensional mark can be applied for. Nevertheless, there are different factors that come under notice during the assessment of the application for three-dimensional marks. Other well-known three-dimensional marks comprise Kit Kat chocolates with wedgies and the shape of Zippo lighters and Coca-Cola bottles. Now, the non-conventional trademarks continue to remain a contemporary concept. Their registration is encircled by barriers. The difficulties associated with the registration of non-conventional trademarks are proof of the development as well as the growth of intellectual property law and must be viewed as stepping stones to the incorporation of modern methods of differentiating one's business. For further information and assistance regarding trademark registration, you can contact us on the given details below for any needed help. Other than that, we have a lot of videos coming up on a lot of topics with a lot of information to learn. So do let us know if you need any more information about any other topic in the comment box below. Until then, I'll see you in the next video. Take care. Bye-bye.